money.
Hello, Garfield. We were about to give you up.
Gentlemen, I'm sorry I'm late. I was unexpectedly delayed.
Well, if your reason is good enough, we'll excuse you.
Best in the world. I sent some flowers to a lady. I had to wait in line.
Oh, competition, eh? Well, you got to expect that at our age.
In line at the flower shop, gentlemen. They're for my best girl.
Why, you old reprobate.
She's my daughter, April. Tomorrow's her birthday. They're having a party for her at school. I couldn't go on account of this meeting. Why this emergency meeting? Anybody know?
Charles called it himself. He's done okay so far. I'll back him with all I've got.
Not me. I'm in it up to my last dollar.
Good morning, gentlemen.
Good morning. Good morning. Good morning.
Gentlemen, I have stolen $6 million from you. I'm sorry, gentlemen. My judgment on the market went wrong. You have two courses open. You may send me to jail at once, or give me 30 days in which to try and make the loss good.
I'll kill you.
Get Dr. Armitage up here quickly, please.
Gentlemen, the whys and wherefores and recriminations, they solve nothing, pay nothing.
Just a moment.
Listen, child, the board is in favor of granting you the chance you asked for. We're all in too deep. We've got to play along.
Thank you. We'll meet here 30 days from tonight at 8:30.
I warned you, Garrett, 2 years ago, that disease of the heart valve, at your age, will admit of no additional strain or shock.
I know, Arnold. I know.
That's why I advised you to dispose of your business and rest.
If only April didn't have to know.
Does she?
Well, there isn't enough money to keep her at school. Even our home swept out from under us.
It doesn't seem possible.
When I sold my business to Chain, April and I had enough to live comfortably with. I listened to Chires and invested my money in his company.
All of it?
Every dollar. He promised to double it. I'd known him for years, and, well, it looked sound.
Men like Chires have a knack of painting things to look that way.
Only last week I could have sold my holdings at a substantial profit. Chires begged me to hold on, and now everything is gone.
He may pull something out of the wreck, but you've got to take it easy.
Of course, for myself, it doesn't make so much difference. I'm near the end of things. I'm thinking of April. She's just at the beginning. Her mother and I had planned a very different future for her.
Well, she's grown up, isn't she? I haven't seen her since before she left for school.
She'll be 18 tomorrow.
What's the name of that school, Garrett?
Martha Washington School for Girls, Beechwood, Vermont.
With a half moon in three-quarter time, and to half the meaning in rhyme, there'll be dancing and romance till the clock.
Telegram from Miss April Garfield. Sign here, please.
Oh, the song of the melody has. Still our hearts will continue to roam, as on the starlit wind, our song we sang, up to the moon in three-quarter time. More in love and feeling great, you need the sky that Mother Nature has designed, and the spheres incidental to a person's sentimentally inclined. It's your secret, and every month is June. Your love is love to only half a moon. With a half moon in three-quarter time,
my birthday. This is the hat. Thanks to all of
you. This is for you, Miss April.
Prescott, I must leave at once at the Henry.
Better already. Too bad I can't put your daughter's brand of medicine in the bottle. Then I could retire. You take it easy, Garrett, and I'll drop in tomorrow.
All right, Anna. Thank you.
You'll be back on his feet before you know it. Just guard against the sight of the shock, that's all.
How bad is
that? Pretty bad, my dear. He had a shock that almost finished him. It's mostly mental now. He's concerned about you, giving up all this, your future. He knows how much you love this house.
Oh, I do. It's going to hurt. But I love him more.
Well, you have to take over from here. I submit my patient to the superior skill of Dr. April Garfield. Good night, my dear.
Good night.
Isn't the homecoming I planned for you, dear?
Just seeing you is enough. I hated being away from you, Dad. We had every day, every minute of it.
You're so young to be facing the world.
Nonsense. I've had my back to it much too long. It's time I turned around. Besides, there's a very simple formula for facing the world. Just roll up the sleeves and go to work.
Work? What could you do?
Well, they told me at school I was a singer. Right now is a pretty good time to find out.
Music is part of your education, honey.
Yes, the part that costs you the most. And I'm going to try to get some of it back. But the first move will be out of this house.
Out of this house?
No excitement.
But it's your home. You were born here.
It's a mausoleum, Dad. A decayed, musty old place full of ghosts of dead things. And I hate it. We're going to move. 8:30. Dad, there's a special program every Wednesday night at this time. We never miss it at the school. Do you mind?
Ladies and gentlemen, Polo Cigarettes present Mike Goes to a Party.
Hello out there. This is your host, Dave Ball. Mike Goes to a Party is an entirely spontaneous, informal, and unrehearsed program. Mike is a party crasher, appearing uninvited at social gatherings, reporting on-the-scene doings of a nation at play after dark. Incidentally, ladies and gentlemen, Mike is short for microphone. Tonight, the wayfaring Mike goes to the Swank Embassy Club to cover a bond rally. It's the party of the year, just like a kid's dream of Christmas. Now I'd like to introduce my assistant, Shadow. Say good evening to the radio audience, Shadow.
Hello, Sadie. Tell your old man not to worry about his tuxedo. I'm taking very good care of it.
That's Shadow, always kidding.
Who's kidding?
Come on. We are now inside the main ballroom.
Good evening, Mr. Barrington.
Good evening.
Looks like your party's going to be a great success.
Thank you, Mr. Ball.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Mrs. Elizabeth Barrington, the hostess of this brilliant affair. Looks like everybody's here. Your party's a grand idea for a bond rally. They tell me each guest had to buy a $1,000 war bond to get in.
It's going to cost them more than that to get out.
Well, I'm sure the whole nation joins me in saluting your fine impulse in turning over your beautiful Long Island estate to the wounded soldiers. You've certainly done your share.
They're more than welcome. Excuse me.
Surely. That's Larry Daly and his band you hear playing, ladies and gentlemen. It's going to be a gala night and a great show. We'll cut into the loudspeaker system and bring it to you. Hook it up, Shadow.
How's about giving out with a song, boss? You want to do your bit, don't you? What about it, Larry?
Fine. How about April, David?
Well, thank you, Larry.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. David Ball singing I'll Remember April.
That song's about you, honey.
Yes.
Long the day will lengthen into evening. We'll sigh goodbye to all we've ever had. Alone, where we have walked together. I won't forget, but I won't be lonely. I'll remember April
and our smile.
Ladies and gentlemen, tonight's master of ceremonies, none other than that fearless news analyst and commentator, the man whose news and views are listened to by 50 million people nightly. Here he is, Mr. Bill Winchester.
Thank you, Harry.
Our country's welfare should be the first concern of every American. And when we promote that, we're only doing our duty. So when your country calls, dig, brothers, and dig deep. Remember, every bond you buy is a soldier's ticket home. Now let's get on with the show.
To barge around here and see if you can't pick up an item or two for the broadcast and column tomorrow.
Oh, no, it's my night off. Besides, I have my eye on a special little item of my own.
I see what you mean. Why don't you give your listeners, if any, a break and let your stooge handle that thing? I want to talk to you.
You're as funny as a cry for help, Snooper.
Stay with the band, Shadow. You know there's such a thing as ethics in this business?
How would you know that?
I think it's only fair to warn you, Davy. I'm after you since the cross you slipped me on that refugee story.
Since when is a scoop a cross? You'd pay a guy to throw a baby out a window for a story. But that leg man on the dailies beats you to a yarn and you holler murder and bleed lemon juice for a week.
Don't play dead with me, Davy. You knew my man was on the dock at the telephone ready to give me the dope on the Gripsholm landing, and you knew that.
I knew the Gripsholm was due, so I took a mic aboard at quarantine. It was news, Willie. That's my racket, too.
All right. This is my show tonight. Get that?
Not quite.
Colonial Cigarettes have an exclusive on me, pal, and if you broadcast one word I say out of this room tonight, they'll sue Polo for $1 million and get it, including your neck.
$1 million? You're too modest.
I'm warning you, Davy.
Allow me.
Thanks.
Good, huh?
Good little dancing act.
No, I mean the cigarette.
Are you kidding? The best cigarette made.
You know, that's what they all say. It's amazing, ladies and gentlemen, how the world is switching to Polo cigarettes.
Polos?
And so until the same time, same station, next Wednesday evening at 8:30, when we broadcast from a honky-tonk just off Lower Broadway, this is Dave Ball saying thank you and good night for Polo Cigarettes.
Night, Mr. Ball, and thank you.
1, 2, 3, 4, test. Okay.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's Wednesday night again, and once more, Mike goes to a party. Tonight's frolic takes place at the Happy Hour Cafe on a side street just off Broadway, a rendezvous for the lower bracket nightlife addicts. We'll go inside and give it the double O. Come on, Shadow.
We are now inside this paradise of checkered tablecloths and noise. There are several couples on the dance floor tearing themselves apart. Folks, it's jitterbugging. Is really jumping. And it's a big jump, ladies and gentlemen, from the flesh and pencil of last week's party at the embassy to the Happy Hour Cafe. But I'm sure the folks here are having as much fun in their own way, if not more. My friends, this, as you all know, is that popular program, Mike Goes to a Party. Now just be yourselves, have fun, just as though we were here. There's a brand new $10 bill to anyone who can help to make this program more interesting. And for everybody, plenty of those mild, cool Polo cigarettes, all for free. All right, where do we start?
Gotta get home, it can't.
harbor lights are in sight. We're gonna paint that town and then we're gonna stop and start all over again. We got a black book with names galore and pretty girls by the score. We're gonna dance and sing, do everything, do it up just right, 'cause we're hitting the beach, hitting the beach tonight. 'Cause we're hitting the beach tonight, our shoes are shining their bright. We've got our duds all clean and fresh, put on our hats and know we look our best. The captain said, when you hit town, and when you start to look around, if you find two or three,
hey, say one for me.
Just be sure she's right, 'cause we're hitting the beach tonight.
That was the Navy, ladies and gentlemen, and a swell job. Now who'll it be? This gentleman here, your name, please?
Joe Billings.
Well, Joe, what's your business?
By profession, I am a window washer.
Sounds like an interesting occupation. Bet you see a lot of things, don't you, Joe?
I sure do. Anytime you want to see a sample of my work, just step down to the Equity Trust Building.
Remind me to do that. You come here often, Joe?
Every night, right at this table.
Private table and everything, huh? You like the show?
Yeah, I got talent, too. I do imitations.
Oh, I was afraid of that.
What kind of imitation?
Ooh, animal cries and barnyard noises. Want to hear them?
All right, Joe, if you must, try a couple. Mr. Joe Billings, animal noises. That was great, Joe. Terrific. $10 to Mr. Billings.
Thank you.
Now, who will it be?
How, Sugar? Are you all by yourself?
Yes.
Well, then why can't we get together? Pardon me.
Here we have a beautiful girl all by herself. What's your name, Miss?
April.
April what?
Smith.
I sang a song about you last week.
Yes, I heard you. I'll remember April.
I promise to do just that from tonight on.
What?
Remember April.
30 days has November, April,
quiet.
June.
What are you doing down here?
Well, I came down to see you, Mr. Ball. I was about to give up the search for you when I saw your truck outside.
At last I get a break. Would you like to say something on the air?
I'd rather sing it if you don't mind.
I certainly do not. Come right ahead. What would you like to sing?
Do you think they know Too Much to Wish For?
Sure. Too Much to Wish For. Hit it, boys.
$10 bill to Miss April Smith for her beautiful song.
Thank you.
What's the matter with you, Muggs? Ain't you had no bringing up? Can't you see they want to hear the little lady sing?
Go on, beat it, or bend that telephone around your neck.
You'll bend what telephone around whose neck?
You heard what the man said, beat it.
Oh, are you going to stand for this? Could I speak to you for a minute?
Sure, right after the broadcast. Stick around.
But
you should. So get out. Wait a minute, Pop. They ain't paid their check yet.
Well, we ain't going to pay it. Come on, let's get out of this honky-tonk.
Oh! Now she calls a maid joint a honky-tonk. This is a...
Looks like there's going to be trouble, folks. If a fight starts, I'll give you a ringside blow-by-blow description. It is our job to deliver to you just exactly what happens when Mike goes to a party and...
You try to spoil nice, pretty lady's singing. Now you try to give a maid joint a bad name. Get out!
It looks like anything can happen here.
Would you care to say a word to the listening audience, my friend?
Say something, Shadow, or can't you talk?
Hello, Mama. It was a great fight.
Good morning, children.
Good morning, Mr.
Joan, everything all right?
Fine, Mr. Ball.
How's your shorthand these days?
Oh, it's good as ever.
Boss! Hey, come with me quick.
What's the matter?
J.C. wants to see you. He's got half the brains of the Polo Cigarette Company in there with him. Hurry up, David.
Okay,
look at
okay, you. But don't get so excited. Good morning, gentlemen. It was a great program we had last night, wasn't it? That fight was...
Where did you find her?
Yes, and who is she really?
Sensational discovery, Ball. Sensational.
Who are you talking about? The girl in the program last night. The one who sang.
Yes, April Smith.
Oh, that one. Well, that was just some girl.
Just some girl.
Now, see here, Dave. That girl created the sensation. Who is she?
And how soon can you get her here?
You mean you liked her?
Liked her? A couple of million people went crazy about her. Look at the wires.
They all want to know who she is and when she's going to sing again. Get her up here right away. I'm going to sign her for our Bandmaster program. Starts tomorrow night. Well, I...
Call her up now and tell her.
I can't.
Why not?
I don't know who she is or where to find her.
Are you kidding?
Her name is April Smith. You had her on your program.
I know, but she was just some girl I saw in that joint. I
say, if you're holding her out for some private deal or if she signs with some other company, you're fired. So you better start looking for her.
Shadow, here.
Here, boss.
Call up all the Smiths and ask for April.
All of them?
Yeah.
My boss, there must be 7 pages of Smiths, maybe more.
I don't care if there's 107. Call them.
Okay.
Not here. I want to use these lines with the agency. She may be registered to one of them. Here. Go get yourself a flock of nickels and use the booth phone in the lobby.
Smith. Pages of them. Nothing but Smith.
Their weeds now. Frying them?
They're frying, all right. Listen.
Miss April Smith, why couldn't have been Ginsburg or April Mahoney or something? Leave him alone. I'll pick him up.
Well, I was only trying to help
you. Well, I can help myself.
Yes. That's what I said, April Smith. Never heard of her, huh?
And you'll wish you hadn't if you don't find her.
I've got it. Put me on the Bandmaster program tomorrow night and I'll broadcast for her.
All right. But she'd better be listening in.
Hey, clear out. You've been in there long enough to make 20 calls. Oh, how do you like that?
I knew you would.
Do I? This is going to be one for little Davy's book.
It ought to even the score between you two cutthroats if you can find her first.
If I can find her, I'll do more than find her. Sister, you don't know how long I've been waiting for this. Get me Mr. Taylor. Ball behind his own eight ball. Hello, Harry. Bill, listen, boss. Your troubles with that prima donna on your program are over. Can I fix her? You tell that would-be thrice she can walk and walk quick. No, wait a minute. I'm going to deliver into your ever-loving hands none other than Miss April Smith. Polo, don't make me laugh. Give a listen to my broadcast tonight. Yeah, my girl Whisper dug her up. That's right. Okay, Harry, I'll be seeing you.
Is there an April Smith in the house?
Hello, everybody, north, south, east, and west. This is Willie Winchester broadcasting the nightly edition of the newspaper The Air. The events of the moment, some sad, some glad, but all true. Gathered from the far corners of the universe through the facilities of the World Press.
And it's a bouncing boy for the Ridgeways. Mama's doing nicely. Let's hope Papa somewhere in Italy is doing the same. Hiya, Rich. Congratulations. And now, ladies and gentlemen, your attention, please. If Miss April Smith, the girl who sang so beautifully from the Happy Hour Cafe last night on the You Know What program, will phone me at once here at the Universal Broadcasting Studio, it will be decidedly to her benefit. I repeat, if Miss April Smith will phone me at once here at the studio, it will be decidedly to her benefit. April, are you listening?
Yes, I am.
What is all this?
Dad, did you hear that?
Yes, it's too bad your last name isn't Smith.
But it is. I mean, it was last night.
What do you mean?
Think of it. Bill Winchester. I've got to make a phone call.
To whom?
Mr. Bill Winchester.
April! Well,
leave everything to me, honey. Now, you put on the best dress you own and be down in front of your place in 15 minutes. That's right. All right, fine. I'll see you later. Goodbye.
You're sure you have the right one?
Sure. She knows all the answers. Look, I want you to go right over and pick her up. Here's the address. Take her over to your place and keep her out of sight. I'll meet you there.
What do I tell her?
That I've adopted her. Now get going.
With the speed of an athlete.
Oh, I want to see that.
Never mind the cracks.
That rat. That dirty rat.
It's a calamity. That's what it is. Murder. I'll kill that guy. Maybe she wasn't listening to him.
50 million people listen to that worm every night. She was listening, all right. He probably got her on the phone right now.
What'll he do with her?
Do with her? Put her on the Songs You Love program for his firm. Just to cut my throat.
Well, boss, what do we do?
Something and fast. Come on.
Miss Smith?
Oh, yes.
I'm Whisper.
Yes, I'm seeing your picture in the paper.
They needed a space filler. So you're what all the fuss is about.
Fuss?
Yes. It looks like you've hit the jackpot, honey.
So glad Mr. Winchester heard me and liked me.
Oh, he likes you all right. In fact, he's nuts about you.
I just can't believe it. Where are we going?
Up to my apartment. Mr. Winchester will meet us and explain.
I see. That's very thoughtful of him.
He's a very thoughtful man. Very.
Yes. Oh, by the way, do you know David Ball?
Who?
David Ball, the man on the Mike Goes to a Party program?
I think I've heard of him. Why?
Well, I wanted to call him and thank him. You see, he's really responsible for getting me this break.
Yes, do. I'm sure he'd appreciate it.
You know, you're liable to get a lot of phony offers after my broadcast tonight, so I thought I'd better hide you away for your own protection.
Whatever you think is best, Mr. Winchester.
Well, here we are. Be it ever so humble.
Oh, that's lovely.
Won't you sit down?
Thank you.
No, please, it's the pianist, Smith. I want to hear that song of yours again.
Covered every hotel in New York. You owe me $26 for taxi fare.
Okay, okay. I've looked everywhere but the jail. Certainly got her buried.
Maybe we ought to try the cemetery.
Hello?
Hello, Dave. This is Bill Winchester.
You. Listen, you. Now, Davey, old boy, I've been trying to get you for the past hour. Where have you been? Davey, old boy, such language. Look, chum, what I called you about is that I have something very interesting I thought you'd like to hear.
There is so much to wish for. That's why I wish not. So glad will I find happiness.
That's fine, thanks. Well, what did he... Now what?
We've got to find that hideout.
I can think of 6 million places he might have her stowed away.
How about a drink, huh?
What was all that for?
Mr. Winchester wanted a friend of his to hear you, too.
Did I do all right?
Honey, it was swell.
You're always going to do all right.
It's funny how things turn out.
You can say that again. One man's meat is another man's poison.
Morning. We ain't talking to you. Well, maybe we are. Now listen, you. It was a dirty trick. It was unethical.
I'm sure. I don't know what you're talking about.
Well, you don't, huh?
And don't give me that line about ethics.
Netherlands. Going up.
Thank you so much. Chambermaid? Chambermaid?
I didn't know.
It's dusting day every Friday. It won't take me long. Just once over lightly. I'll just put this right here.
Are you sure you have the right apartment?
Oh, yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. I had a hard time finding it.
What?
Oh, I mean my new glasses. I can't see numbers very good.
Why do you wear them?
Oh, just vanity, just vanity.
Haven't I seen you somewhere before?
Oh, I get around. But haven't I seen you somewhere before? Are you a movie star?
No, I'm trying to be a singer.
Oh, where do you sing?
Well, I've just started.
I must catch you sometime.
You just sit right down over there. I'll give you a sample.
Oh, that's very nice of you, dear. Thank you so much.
Oh, did you hurt yourself?
Oh, no, dear.
Why don't you throw those awful glasses away?
Oh, I couldn't do that. We girls have such a hard time keeping ourselves attractive. Make it snappy, sister. I gotta get out of here. I mean, I've got to get back to work.
There's a jingle, jing, jing, jing that I always love to sing whenever I wear. Has the cutest little swing. Remember, it goes just like this. Some sweet manana down by the ocean blue. I'll strum chatter-boo, chatter-boo, hum chatter-boo. and together we'll chat a boom doodle.
I'm no good at rhythm.
I'm not supposed to tell anyone, but you look honest. You won't say anything, will you?
Oh, so help me.
Well, I'm going to be on the Colonial Cigarette Program tonight for Mr. Winchester. I'm so excited.
So am I. I mean, good luck, my dear. I really must go now. The door, take me to it, dear.
Oh.
I'll police up the joint later.
Remember, you promised not to tell anyone.
Oh, so help me.
Hey, look out. Don't forget anything.
I'll pick it up later, my dear.
Boy, did I put it over.
Where did you learn that female impersonation act?
I played Charlie's aunt, the school play.
Do they have plays in reform school?
Never mind.
Give me the boss. Dave Ball calling.
Tell him I want a raise.
Hello, J.C. We found her.
We found her? Huh.
Well, it's about time.
Winchester's going to put her on the Colonial program tonight. Now, keep your shirt on, J.C. I mean, he was. You hold that spot open on your Bandmaster show tonight.
You idiot, Winchester show goes on at the same time.
Put on another network. I've got an angle.
It had better be good.
Good evening. Call you a cab?
Please. Nervous, honey? I'm afraid I am.
Relax. There's nothing to worry about.
There you are.
Hey there!
What are you doing? Why, Mr. Ball.
Hello, honey. Sorry to frighten you like that, but I had to do it.
But I don't understand. Where are we going?
To the broadcast. You don't know, but you almost got kidnapped.
I did?
You betcha. A couple of gangsters were going to snatch you and put the squeeze on the Colonial Cigarette people.
But why would they want to kidnap me? I haven't any money.
No, but Colonial has, and you're worth a lot to them.
I am?
You've no idea. Winchester just heard about it, and he asked me to bring you over to the broadcast. Figured it'd be safer that way.
Gee, I can't thank you enough.
It's okay, honey. I wanted to see you again anyway.
I was going to call you to thank you for putting me on your program that night. I never would have gotten this chance if it hadn't been for you.
You don't have to thank me. I was glad to do it.
Well, thanks anyway.
Driver.
Yes, sir.
Why are we going in this way?
Back at them. The stars use it to skip the crowds out front.
Oh. That's the first time I ever rode in a freight elevator.
You'll get used to it. After tonight, you'll be right on top of that star wagon.
If I am, I have you to thank, and Mr. Winchester.
Let us not forget Mr. Winchester.
Well, here she is.
My dear Miss Smith, let me be the first to welcome you to
yes,
the boat.
Yes, she's here and all set to sail. Looks like we just made it. Come on.
Ladies and gentlemen, a few nights ago, the wandering Mike Goes to a Party discovered a brand new singing star. And now, in response to your demand, we present her at the microphone. Miss April Smith singing Dawn.
Oh, but I was going to sing
we that. Had to change it at the last minute. Coco Soap used the song just ahead of us. You know the song, don't you?
Yes, sir.
You're on, honey. Good luck.
What's the matter with that guy? I didn't he say Polo Cigarettes present April Smith?
Maybe he got tired of mentioning those weeds.
Well, I'll fire him.
Yeah. Tune in on the Polo Cigarette program, Willie. Right now.
Did it work? I mean, where to?
East 63rd Street. All right, Mr. Ball. You may start talking.
What?
Please, I'm not stupid.
I don't get you, honey.
I sang on the Bandmaster program tonight, didn't I? That's your company, isn't it? Not Winchester. Yours.
How'd you know?
Network letters on the mic?
I think it went through like a sport. What are they?
That calls for an explanation, don't you?
I guess it does. Okay, honey, you win. Happened like this. I was desperate. I was about to lose my job. Oh, that's my story.
Wonderful. Except that you read in the magazine.
It's the truth, so help me.
Well, if I had the same effect on the rest of my audience, I won't get very far in radio.
Sorry, dear. I was proud of you tonight.
This is my father, Mr. Ball.
How do you do?
Glad to meet you, Mr. Smith.
My name is Dolphy.
I use Smith so I wouldn't disgrace the family name.
But you can go back to your real one now. You're in. Your daughter has a great future, Mr. Garfield.
You may not have to bother with a career after next Wednesday.
No, Dad, that's a secret. You two sit down and get acquainted. I'll look up something more to you.
Sit down.
Thank you. What's the big secret about next Wednesday? Wednesday's my day, you know.
Well, it's a little private matter.
Would it help you any to talk about it?
It might. You know the Equity Investment Company, don't you?
Yes, that's Childs' company.
Yes. 3 weeks ago, Mr. Childs announced to the board of directors that he had stolen $6 million from us.
What?
Yes, for 30 days, he tried to make restitution. His time is up next Wednesday night.
There must be thousands of depositors in that company.
Rich and poor. Every one of them cleaned out of their life savings.
And you?
Every dollar I own.
That's terrible, sir.
I don't know what's going to happen to Chires at that meeting. He doesn't come through.
Where are you holding the meeting?
In the boardroom of the Equity Trust.
Supper for three, coming up.
Service is good here. We'll get no better at the Waldorf tomorrow.
Thank you.
I mean the table equipment. Finest linen, exquisite china, sterling silver.
Some relics we salvaged from the wreck. We once had a very nice home, Mr. Ball.
You'll have it all again.
On the air in a minute. Give me all the power you can.
Right.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. The
It's 8:30 Wednesday night, and once again, Polo Cigarettes brings you Mike Goes to a Party. Tonight, Mike goes to a different kind of a party, unrehearsed as usual. In fact, the leading characters of our broadcast won't even know they're on the air. Has he come in yet?
No.
I think I'll just have time to explain our setup here before the main character arrives.
Oh, hello, Garfield.
Hey, here, Garfield.
And so tonight, we will attempt to bring you the payoff from our hidden microphone and the inkwell on the table. Hurry, we're on the air.
It's after 8:30.
He just came in.
Here we are, ladies and gentlemen. Mr. Child has just entered. We're switching now to Mike in the inkwell.
How are you,
Doc? The next voice you hear will be that of Mr. Child. Take it away, Mike.
Gentlemen, I regret to announce that I have been unable to make good on the money. You may call the police.
Why, you... Why?
What do you mean you're unable to make good? You've had 30 days.
Lights are on now, and Child flies across the table. This is murder, ladies and gentlemen. And you can believe me, Mike never expected anything like this.
But I'm talking to you, Chief, outside of your badge, outside of your office. Garfield didn't do it. You've got the wrong man.
The dead man ruined Garfield, didn't he? That's motive. Garfield threatened the dead man 30 days ago. That's premeditation. This bullet, according to our ballistics experts, was fired from the gun Garfield held when we arrested him. Plus, no prints on the gun but Garfield's. That's evidence.
So you're satisfied Garfield did it, huh?
We've got to be till after the inquest. If you're Garfield's friend, your best move is to get him a lawyer.
I'll do more than that, Chief. I'll get you the man who killed Child.
Good luck to you, son.
Come in.
April.
Oh, Dave.
That's all right, honey. Go ahead and cry. Do you good.
But he didn't do it. I know he didn't.
Just get that through your head and you'll be all right.
You were there. You must have seen.
The lights were up.
Then why are you so sure?
Listen, your father gave me the whole setup about the meeting. He knew I was going to broadcast it. Now, it just doesn't make sense that he'd go there with a gun and murder Child with me in the next room broadcasting.
Then who did kill him?
Oh, yeah. I'm going to find out. You go to bed and get some rest. I'll call you first thing in the morning.
Dave.
Yeah?
You're swell.
That'll help on those long winter evenings.
Me for help. After all you've done to me, I shouldn't live so long.
All that stuff you spout in the air about being the champion of the underdog is a lot of bunk, huh?
All you have to do is look at the records, pal.
That's what I'm doing, your record. You've helped to bring more guys to justice than the whole police force combined.
Look, Garfield stood there with a gun in his hand. Now, how do you get around that?
He said he picked it up from the floor.
Well, you don't believe that, do you?
Of course I do.
Hey, Bill. Sorry I bothered you.
Wait a minute. Now you're breaking my heart. Okay, I'll solve your murder for you, but on my terms.
What?
That I get the exclusive on it.
You've got it.
Okay, let's go.
Where?
Look, boy, Changes. Did it ever occur to you to find out why the lights went out at precisely that moment?
Somebody turned them out.
Maybe. Maybe not. I'll find out.
Thank you.
stop on the Cook's tour of the building?
Yeah, it could be. I want to check this list of investors in the Child Company. You know, everybody in these files had the same motive Garfield did.
Wait a minute, Sherlock. Dr. Watson takes over from here.
It had to be somebody besides Garfield who knew the exact moment the lights were going out in the building.
That's right. He could have.
I don't know him. It's just a hunch. Well, you got to have evidence, son, to pin a crime like this on a man.
We're smart. He may pin it on himself.
If your hunch is right, I can make him do just that.
Do you mind if I go along? Just for the ride?
Not at all. Glad to have you.
Thank you.
But in the back seat, I'm driving.
Gentlemen, I'm Dave Ball. This is the Mike Goes to a Party program. The last time we were here, we liked it so much, we're back again. Now, we go on the air in about a minute. During the broadcast, I'd like to ask you to be perfectly quiet, no matter what you see or hear. Thank you very much.
Almost time, Sonny boy.
Yeah, maybe our luck will hold out.
Don't worry. If this crazy idea works, we may all go home together.
We're in. Get going, Bill.
I'm on my way.
What's this all about? Sit tight, honey. Those two play long shots. They know more tricks than Houdini, and some of them work.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Dave Ball bringing you another Wednesday night program of Mike Goes to a Party for Polo Cigarettes. We have every reason to expect tonight's program will be even more interesting and exciting than last Wednesday night when Mike went to a murder party. Pause a moment for station identification. The stage is set in exact reproduction of the scene of the murder last Wednesday night. Actors are in the same places at the table. They're grimly silent as they sit, waiting. Mr. Garfield, the accused, sits near the end of the table. Ladies and gentlemen, the man who killed Henry Childs last Wednesday night is in this room. His name is not Garfield. Mr. Childs has just entered. He's been taking his place at the head of the table.
Gentlemen, I regret to announce I have been unable to make good on the money. You may call the police.
What do you mean? You can't make good. You have 30 days.
There he goes, Dave. Here, hold this up. Don't lose anything. Where are you going, Billings?
All right, Billings, this is it.
You killed Childs, didn't you?
But he's not dead. Nobody killed him. I just saw him.
You're a liar, Billings. Come clean. Get it off your chest.
But I did nothing. I had to... I didn't do it.
Yes, you did. You weren't satisfied to kill one man. You tried to murder two.
Two?
Yes.
You thought you could walk the streets free and sit here and lap up beer while an innocent man burns in the chair in your place.
But you're crazy, all of you. Don't look at me that way. Who's that? Who's that?
That's Childs. That's the man you killed. That's the man that's going to walk beside you every step you take the rest of your life.
Come on, Billings. Talk.
I killed him. I had it all timed. I knew to the minute when the engineer switched the dynamos over in the building. I was outside the window, hooked to my safety belt. I fired the shot and tossed the gun into the room. I didn't think he'd ever find out. Anyhow, he robbed me, didn't he? Didn't he?
That's murder, Billings. There's no compromise with the law. Have you got that, Shadow?
All right, boys, take him downtown. My regards to the chief, and tell him here's the killer I promised him.
Okay. Come on, Billings.
You know, Bill, that was the most exciting one-night stand I ever played.
You gave a great performance, Eddie. Thanks.
Thank you very much.
Don't mention it. Glad to be of service.
Here you are, Maestro.
Thanks, Whisper. There it is, ladies and gentlemen. Mike witnessed the murder and now has brought you...
Don't forget who's got the exclusive on this, pal.
Sure, Bill, go right ahead.
Well, thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Bill Winchester. You've just heard the confession of Henry Childs' murder. The crime solved, as usual, by your favorite newsboy who broadcasts nightly for Colonial Cigarettes. The only thing I can say for Polo Cigarettes is that when you read that name backwards, it spells... Olap. There you are, John.
Okay, Bill, and thanks for the plug.
What plug?
Here you are, honey. This'll take care of your daddy.
Thank you, Dave.
Hey, look. What's in the air?
Well, folks, it's 9 o'clock, and this is Shadow signing off for the boss. He seems to be pretty busy right now. And from where I stand, it looks like one of these Wednesday nights, Mike may go to a wedding.